That man, Bill Cosby, has made the news again. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Cosby was denied parole, and we're about to read and follow on the regular news on what they got to report about Bill the Man Cosby. And it's kind of sad. It's kind of unfortunate. Today, Bill Cosby, we know the pandemic is going on. Bill Cosby had high hopes of being approved of release from prison today, and he got the news he didn't expect, but he said he did expect. He got denied today, and the attempt from the parole board denial was due to the fact that Bill Cosby was given a judgment of going to counseling and therapy for offenders. Now, I need you guys to understand what type of offenders. Offenders who do annoying things and go throughout the ways of getting caught up in the situational needs. Now, Bill Cosby doesn't see himself as a offender of you know what type of assaults. Bill Cosby is not remorseful, a lot of the sources are reporting. They said because of this, they gave Bill Cosby a 3 strikes and you're out. Multiple times, they've asked Bill Cosby repeatedly, he has to go through therapy. Now, Bill Cosby and his attorney, well, Cosby rep, that is, Andrew White, tells TMZ, Bill isn't surprised by the denial because members of the parole board told him he would be denied if he didn't participate in the offenders program. He's not giving up hope, is what Mr. Cosby said. His request for parole through White tells us Cosby is hopeful that the Pennsylvania State Supreme Court will vacate his conviction and potentially grant him a new trial. Now, if this man does get a new trial, then it'll be helpful. But if you look at the latter of things, I don't think anybody is thrilled with Mr. Cosby and what he's been doing. Now, the parole board is his only chance of ever seeing his family again because a lot of people are saying his health has declined. He is not in good spirits. And a lot of people are out, as you see, subjectively out to get him. A lot of his peers are like, when they have conversation with Cosby, he really emphatically protests his innocence. He is mad and angry, and because of that, his protest is basically he's going through fits of not eating food, of not going through regular counseling, of not speaking in a form of where the magistrate that day, you know, can perceive as remorseful or that he cares. And you guys got to remember, as you know, Cosby in September of 2018 was sentenced 3 to 10 years in prison after conviction of aggravated indecent assault of Andrea Constand at his home in 2004. Now, this is something that was repeatedly. Now, this is not for all the other women that they accused Mr. Cosby of. Remember, this is just for one of the women. So now, can the other cases be opened up? I don't know. I did read reports where people are still trying to open cases against Cosby. So I guess this is their way of saying, please show remorse so we can let you go home. But I think even if he does show remorse, they're out to get him. They're in a way, in a shape and form to make sure this man doesn't have the day in light in public's opinion nor perspective. They basically canceled him throughout every form of networking outlets that you can think of. Now, Cosby is not perceived to be the man that he once was. The witty, funny, comedian, host, philanthropist, so many things he was. And now, in a matter of 1 year alone, he basically is shut down now. His television show, The Cosby Show, and the Fat Albert series, along with a string of other things that have his image and likeness in, has been canceled and stopped. So a lot of the actors are not even getting paid anymore. We've seen one of the guys working at Ranger Joe's. We've seen a lot of things throughout the actors of the Cosby Kids. I mean, Theo and so many others were shocked. Some still profess Cosby innocent. They stand by him. While others have been away from Cosby and made sure they're waiting until they get more evidence. Now, can Cosby get another trial? That's yet to be determined. But because he has yet to consult through a therapist and go through therapy, they look at it as he can do the same things again. I'm not even saying he's guilty, but this is what the courts and the Pennsylvania parole board is perceiving Cosby to being confrontational, not taking adhesion to his attorney's advice or other substantial figures in his life and in this case. Several people and trained professionals tried to get Cosby to understand that at his age and the way he's going, he's gonna probably be forced to do the whole sentence. They're probably gonna force Mr. Cosby to go through the whole 10 years, and I don't think at the shape he's in right now he can battle a court again. So I feel like at Cosby's best interest, it's not proclaiming that you're guilty, but at least go through the steps that perceives you to be a changed man, even if you don't feel you're in the right. Because clearly I feel like they're not gonna let you get out early. I feel they're gonna keep Cosby in this web and entanglement of whether you believe their lies or accurate information was given. Because now there's so many people coming out, and people are still coming out. Well, we are well past 2018, and folks are still coming out. Sorry for that cough. I am having a mask on right now. But Cosby, he seems to get a substantial support from a lot of the Cosby fans and supporters. A lot of people who love the show growing up, they love the atmosphere of family-oriented man that he showed he was. The doctor and lawyer relationship between him and his wife. The well-to-do kids having the typical suburbia family problems. I mean, it was a beautiful thing to see. A black family going through the hurdles of life, and now to be brought down through the lies and deception. I mean, that's what they're now showing to us in a grass reality of things. I'm hoping Cosby can overcome this, but they're saying he's stubborn. Now, his lawyer White also said Cosby has been getting acknowledgement from his wife, who's also hoping that he goes through the therapy. So there's a lot of things internally going on. There's back and forth with him and his wife, how she feels he should take this case. Apparently, sources are saying she doesn't feel he should fight it in prison. He should fight it out of prison, meaning that serve his sentence, get out, and then fight to vacate that sentence and vacate that reputation that has tarnished his legacy and his brand. I don't know if there's a way Cosby can get out of this. I don't know if we'll ever see the Jell-O pudding commercials. I highly doubt it. But if he can save his name and reputation, I agree that any man or woman, they should absolutely fight for your legacy, name, and brand. But I want to ask what one question: at what cost would you go out and fight to save your name and reputation? At what cost would you put your family and friends through just to make sure people remember who you were and what you stood for? What type of moral compass you have as well? Because the name of Cosby was a big brand. Prior to 2018, it was a big brand. It was out here. It was one of the heavy hitters throughout history. And I can tell the amount of money that's been lost, the pride that's been lost, the emotions. And this is for everybody involved, whether you're the liars, the people telling the truth, because I don't know the answer at the end of the day. I only can report the news. So I'm really emphatically hoping that everybody involved gets closure from this. And unfortunately, sometimes the innocent ones have to pay a price. Unfortunately, the way the court systems are set up, the judicial process and system, a lot of people are not going to look at it as fair, even though it's perceived to be fair. A lot of the clips we were showing and watching today, people are using that to say Bill Cosby is guilty. Bill Cosby is a so-called guy that lures people. So I don't know. I'll let you guys be the ones to decide on that. It's kind of sad to see a man that once was held in a prominent position in life to now go down in history as the underling of the worst type of guy throughout history. You guys go to my Instagram, DJ_Bless1, and show some support for the platform. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. Love your family. Love your kids. Stay blessed.